Building an iOS app takes a long time. So you guys are always asking me how to build iOS apps faster. And most of the time I will tell you there are no shortcuts. Except for these 8 mind-blowing websites you probably didn't know existed. Make sure to check out the captions right over here and also check out the description for the direct links for the website that I'm going to talk about today. And the first one is coolors.co. Now, this is where I get inspiration for my color palettes on my apps. And it is at coolors.co. And let's just go and explore the tending palettes because it's super, super awesome. And of course, you may like these and just take a look at these nice, cool color palettes. How do you add them into your projects, you might ask? Well, all you have to do is just hover over these nice colors and just click them, and that color will be copied out to your clipboard, and then you can add it to your Xcode project. It's really, really nice. I've been going at coolors.co several times per month, so it's really, really an amazing thing to have. Now, second one is setapp.com. Now, if you haven't heard of setapp.com, then what have you been doing all along this time? Go ahead and check it out. It's at setapp.com, and it's basically a bunch of useful apps for your Mac and recently for your iOS phone, so your iPhone. And man, I just love this. It is a subscription, but it is really, really nice. So just take a look at all of the apps that they have. Let me just switch right over here to my SETAPP app, and they have it all. So let's just go under all apps. You can see a tremendous amount of apps, lifestyle, creativity, developer tools. I really prefer the developer tools, of course. And a lot more, also security, and newly is available on iOS. So you can have all of these apps on your iPhone also. So go ahead and check out the link down in the description for setapp.com. And next up is an alternative for Zoom. You know, with Zoom, there are some limitations like recording minutes and all of that stuff. You can go ahead and take a look at their pricing for the free tier. But with Brave Talk, and it's at brave.com/talk, you have unlimited private video calls, and it's just in your browser. You don't have to download anything. You just have to open up the browser at brave.com/talk and just click on here, start talk. Now, as you already might be wondering, what's the catch right over here? It says free calls, no limits. Yes, there is a catch. There is a premium version, but it's by far the most well-priced on the old platforms that I have tried out for these kind of video communications. And the free version is up to 4 persons. And the premium is 100 plus. And of course, on the premium, you will be able to record your sessions also. So go ahead and check it out. It's at brave.com/talk. It's super, super amazing. And they do boast that they have a private video calls. Okay. And speaking of video calls, the next website that you might not be well aware of is rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can have a one-on-one Zoom call with me about Swift UI, Swift in general, or maybe if you have a bug in your code, or if you want to learn Swift UI, go ahead and check it out. It's rebeloper.com/mentoring, where I can help you on a 60-minute Zoom call. Now, next up on the list is MOCKY, API mocks for free. Basically, what this does is you create a new mock right over here. And of course, you can manage your mock, all of that. And it has all of this in your browser. So you don't have to have internet connection and all of that stuff. You just create your mocks right over here. And then you just start asking for your API calls. And of course, all of this is for free. Next up on the list is LOREM PICSUM, the LOREM PICSUM for photos. Now, in your iOS projects, when you are building all of your project out, you most probably want to use some mock images, not just mock text, but some mock images. And that's where PICSUM.photos comes in. It's called LOREM PICSUM for the LOREM IPSUM, you know. And you just call on these endpoints and you get these nice images. You can have a specific image, as you can see, static random image, grayscale, blur. And yeah, you know, you just have to create your call and then you get back images. Also, you have a list of images. It's really, really great for mocking up your projects when you are still building them out. And if you don't want to have, you know, this doesn't really work when you don't have internet connection or you don't have service, I would highly recommend LOREM from myself. It's at store.rebeloper.com/LOREM, where you can have LOREM IPSUM and LOREM PICSUM for your iOS apps. So text and images, it does have all of the perks that the LOREM PICSUM site has, all of these nice profile images, random images. It works on UIKit 2 with all the devices. So we have a LOREM IPSUM and a LOREM PICSUM, and it's 100% documented. It's really, really nice. Take a look at it at store.rebeloper.com/LOREM. Now, seventh on the list is OBJGEN. Well, what does this mean? Well, basically, when you are trying to build out your JSON blob, this is, again, building out your projects. When you're trying to build this out, typing all of this out, it's really, really cumbersome. So we have this OBJGEN. Let's just go to the site. So beta5.objectivesamgen.com. And you just select JSON generator. And here you just type out what type of JSON you want to use. Now let's take a look at the demo. As you can see here, we have just an ID number equals name equals John Doe. And here we go. We have name equals John Doe, but in a JSON format. It's really, really handy to just mock up some nice JSON files. And finally, after you have your JSON file mocked up, of course, you want to use them in your Xcode projects. And, you know, you want to have your models. And that's where a QuickType comes in, app.quicktype.io. You just paste in your JSON blob right over here. And then it will spit out a really usable model. As you can see, we have the IDs of type int, and then we have the coding keys. And if we have multiple elements, we have source right over here. It's codable. It's really nice. Also, you can have not just Swift, but a lot more languages and all of these options that you might or might not prefer if you just switch on plain types only, all of that stuff. So it's really, really powerful. Again, it's at app.quicktype.io. Now, all of this is for free. And if you want to know how you can add a currency field into your Swift UI apps, go ahead and check out this video right over here.